Welcome to Pastor Linda's Thought for Today, inspiration for daily living, real faith for real people, believe and become, reach and renew. Beloved, I wish above all things that you would prosper and be in health just as your soul prospers. Live, love, and laugh. Jesus loves you. Know God, know peace, forgive and forget, live with no regrets. Today's thought is meant to make you think deeper, reach higher, and experience God's love, forgiveness, peace, and joy. Get ready to receive from today's thought for today. Looks like we're live streaming on Facebook today. I want to welcome everyone to the Thought for Today program. This is Pastor Linda with the Thought of the Day. And today I have, again, my special guest, Robin Bertram. She is an author, speaker, and she was the host of Freedom Today program, a nationally syndicated program. And so I just want to welcome you, Robin. Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you, Linda. It's a joy and privilege to be with you. Thank you.
I'm so glad you could be here. We're going to talk today about the end times, signs of the times, which I think is really apropos for what's going on in the earth today. You know, as we get started, Robin, do you have something you want to share in the beginning here?
I want to say thank you again, Linda. This just has been on my heart for months now. And so I'm really happy to be able to share some information with your viewers.
We can obviously see that some of those things about persecution are happening right now. I mean, the church has never been, I can't say never, it's been under persecution, and especially in the beginning, but in the time that we live in, I don't know of a time in my lifetime that worldwide, including the United States, that the church has been under persecution like it has. I don't know about you, but what are your thoughts on that?
Well, Linda, I'm telling you, Jesus, when he was on the Mount of Olives and his disciples asked him, what will be the sign of your coming and the end of the age? And Jesus gave them very clear what that would be. As we look at our current events today, it is astounding how many things have already lined up according to Scripture, prophesied hundreds and hundreds of years ago, written in stone right here in our Bible.
Yeah. Amen.
And we can walk out those revelations with clarity and hindsight, understanding what Jesus was saying to his disciples right there on the Mount of Olives. Linda, I'm so excited about this topic. And I would like to just kind of go back and cover a few things that really line up end times for us. One of those things, a major indicator, was when the Jewish people returned to their homeland. And that occurred in 1967. That was the reunification of Jerusalem after the Six-Day War. That is vital because it is written. You know, God made it clear that he would bring his children back. So I think that's an important indicator. The Word of God says, so I will bring them back into their land that I gave their fathers, Jeremiah 16:15. So it's very clear that God prophesied the returning of his people back to Israel. Israel being birthed in a day.
Right.
Now that happened in May 14, 1948. That is so vital because we see in Scripture, just like the prophet Jeremiah, the prophet Isaiah prophesied, he said, who has heard of such thing? Who has seen such thing? Can a land be born in a day? Can a nation be brought forth at once? For as soon as Zion was in labor, she gave birth to her children. And that's Isaiah 66:9. What do we know? That prophetic voice has occurred. So we're seeing these things unfold, Linda, right before our eyes, right before our eyes. The Word of God gives another prophetic proclamation, Isaiah again 35:1. The wilderness and the dry land will be glad. The desert will rejoice and blossom like a lily. Today, Linda, Israel is the greatest exporter of roses in all of Europe. So we can see that prophecy has been fulfilled.
Isn't that amazing? I have been to Israel a couple times, and yes, they have just massive amounts of fields, and I mean, it is a desert. I was told when I was there that they have irrigation systems and stuff that they have. Obviously, God gave them the amazing technology for these irrigation systems and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, for that to happen, obviously they had to be blessed, and God has done amazing things.
It is amazing. And then, Linda, one of the most important things fairly recently that we have witnessed, if you think back, December 6, 2017, President Trump formally recognized Jerusalem as the capital of Israel and moved the embassy, American embassy, from Tel Aviv back to Jerusalem. Now, you might think, well, why is that such a big deal? If you think back in biblical days of Ahab and Jezebel, Ahab moved the capital to Samaria and God was displeased. So, we understand that in the sight of God, his city, Jerusalem, being the capital, is vital. And President Trump made that move. So we saw just a fulfillment of the blessing of God being restored as all these things are coming into being. Now, as we're talking about the last days, we know from Scripture that Israel will be surrounded by conflict. We've seen that our whole life, Linda. We've seen an escalation of that, however, now. We've seen an escalation of globalism, which leads to one world government. We've seen anti-Semitism on the rise, anti-Zionism on the rise. Now, there's always been, for as long as the Bible has been written, this hatred of Israel and God's people. God's people have been hated from the beginning of time. But now, right now, we're seeing a rise across this nation. And this nation, Linda, who stands in union with Israel, why is that important to know? Because in the end times, what we know from Scripture, Israel will stand alone. So if we can morph into this very progressive socialism, country of socialists, which leads to communism, that will remove America's standing with Israel. And what does the word say? Those who stand with Israel will be blessed, and those who stand
Amen.
against Israel will be
Yes.
cursed. So we're watching all this unfold right before our eyes. On college campuses, a true hatred, anti-Semitism on the rise like never before. Now, so I want to take you back to this just a minute. There's an alignment of nations that are surrounding Israel. That's happening right now. A formation of nations that stand against Israel. We're seeing an anticipation of peace. We just witnessed President Trump signing an agreement of peace. If that is not a picture, Linda, of end times, I don't know what is.
Yeah. Oh, I know. I mean, it's so amazing, the biblical, the things in the Bible that are coming to pass. It's amazing.
It's unfolding right
Yeah.
before our eyes. Okay, another one, the preparation to rebuild the third temple. We know this. The first temple was destroyed. I have the dates here. Yeah, in 586 BC, Nebuchadnezzar, we remember that when the first temple was destroyed. The second temple was destroyed, Herod's temple by the Romans in 70 AD. Right now, they are preparing for the third temple to be rebuilt. This is what people need to understand. Right now, right today, 28,000 priests are being trained on how to work in the temple, fulfill the temple duties. They are DNA tested Cohen, the descendants of the high priest of Aaron, 26,000. are being trained right now. The golden menorah has been duplicated. The Levitical musical instruments have already been made. There has been even the red heifer, which is needed for purification of the priests for the Holy of Holies. They have already bred that red heifer. Now, Linda, when you look at all of these things coming together, you're seeing biblical prophecies just unfold and unfold and unfold right before our eyes. This is what we know for certain, and I want to say this. God's judgment comes to this world past, present, and future. And this is what he said. And he said, I will set my glory among the nations, and all nations will see my judgment, which I've executed, and my hand, which I have laid on them. Linda, this is what we don't understand. God's judgment is a time when we see his glory. And if you think about it, right now we're in this pandemic. The judgment of God falls on a land that is defiant to the ways of God. We're at that point right now as a nation. We are at that point. The Word of God also says, be ready. Apostle Paul teaches, be ready. Yeah. You know, as we look at end times, Linda, it's important that you and I, as believers in Jesus Christ, follow what Scripture says. And the Word of God says, no man knows the hour when Jesus comes. No man knows the hour. So sometimes you'll see people pop up and they'll say, well, you know, I'm predicting this and I'm predicting that. That's the clearest sign that they are a false prophet because no man knows the hour. I love that. So the Word of God says this, how will things be when Jesus returns? Well, the Word of God says, it'll be like the days of Noah. People will be eating and drinking and marrying and being given in marriage. So in other words, Linda, it's going to be just a typical day. Just like today is a typical
right.
day. He could return in a twinkling of an eye. Yeah. We could hear the trumpet sound, the sky open, and Jesus could return for his church today.
Right.
Now that's an incredible thought, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, and think about, in the Bible even says that he's coming for those who are looking for him. You know, the example Jesus gave about the virgins, you know, being ready. But Jesus said, you know, he is coming. And Apostle Paul even talked about that. We must be looking for his appearing. We must be anticipating and excited about his return and not just be in a state of, you know, que sera, sera, whatever will be. We need to be aware of his, you know, what are the signs of the times, but we also need to be looking for him because he could come back anytime.
And I love that. So as we look at what's happening in the world right now, and I've got this list, it is not exhaustive, but it's shocking when you put it on paper. Plagues, pandemics, wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes, famines. In this country, record-setting heat waves. Arizona had a temperature of 114 for 44 days in a row.
Wow.
That's incredible. Killer bees. unprecedented swarms of locusts destroying crops in Africa. I mean, that's just unheard of. Riots in the street, an increase in lawlessness and rebellion. And we're seeing that around the world, not just in America, but around the world. A great falling away of the faith. You're yeah. seeing people walking out of the church by large numbers like never before, Linda. Never yeah. before have we seen this kind of falling away. Apostasies in the church. And I think about that in some churches, some denominations who put their seal of approval on homosexual marriage and abortion in the ninth month and all of these social issues that are clearly opposed to God's written word. And I can't help think, Linda, that part of this judgment is to cleanse the temple.
Well, judgment begins in the house of the Lord. It says in 2 Thessalonians 2 and verse 3, it says, let no one deceive you by any means, for that day will not come unless the falling away comes first, and the man of sin is revealed, the son of perdition. So he said, don't be deceived. There will be a day of people falling away first before Jesus comes back. So we definitely are seeing that right now.
We're seeing that. And why is this important? Right now, our country is in reset. And this is so important, Linda. I want to explain something to the viewers I don't know if they've paid attention to or even heard about. But Baphomet, if you want to say, is the symbol and image for the satanic church. Why is that important? This Baphomet is taken from the god of the Greek god of Pan. And why is it important? His lower part of his body was like a goat, and the top half was like a man, and he had horns. Okay, author J.K. Rowling, she revealed a tattoo written in Latin on a wrist. And it says, Salve et Coagula. And that comes from the medieval alchemy, turning base metal into gold, right? That Latin tattoo, Salve et Coagula, dissolve and reassemble. That is exact plan, Linda, for our country right now.
Yeah.
Trying to dissolve the way our country is, and then reestablish it. And there is a push for globalism. And that push for globalism leads to one world government. So there's a breakdown in our society, and it's a satanic push over this nation. That's why Christians need to pray earnestly. We need to stand against the demonic plan. Understand it. Now, I say that, okay, she wrote the Harry Potter books, which all of the kids are reading. All of our kids, our grandkids, unfortunately, they're reading it. She tweeted a Latin phrase out, expecto patrium, which means I await a guardian. We have our guardian, Jesus Christ. But fans of J.K. Rowling are having it inked on their arms and their wrist. That's a mark.
Yeah.
How important is it, Linda, for us to understand right now that phrase that she wrote and kids are putting on their wrist, that's actually a spell. So you have all of these innocent kids that are being deceived into taking a mark that is a demonic mark of the occult. What's the word say? This is what the word says. Now the Spirit expressly says in later times, some will fall away from the faith by devoting themselves to deceitful spirits and teachings of demons. Yeah. And we're seeing that on a national scale, that who would ever dream so many children would be pulled in into the occult. Right now, we're being trained how to accept the coming mark. There's a mark of God and there's a mark of Satan. We're being trained right now through these techniques that Satan is used to infuse his tricks, his schemes, his delusions onto the next generation. Yeah. We have got to be well aware.
Yeah, well, and that's why the Bible says, don't be ignorant of Satan's devices, lest he get an advantage over us. And I hear this, and I've heard it for years, is people say, oh, you know, it's just a book. There's nothing wrong with it, you know, or it's just a movie. But people don't realize that's how deception starts. It starts, you know, with entertainment. It's got to be entertaining or you're not going to watch it. It's got to sound good or you're not going to listen to it. I mean, it's got to be appealing. Satan comes as an angel of light. He's deceived the masses by looking good. And, you know, even the television programs out there are started with Bewitched. You know, I mean, as a kid, you know, we didn't have very many programs to watch, and we watched that. But that's how you got interested in the occult. And I tell you what, people don't realize you mess with the occult and you're going to get burned. You know, it's not anything to play with. You're opening yourself up to a door of the enemy to come in, because the enemy can't come in unless you open a door. Just like Jesus can't come in unless you open the door to your heart to him. Jesus said, I stand at the door and knock, and you have to open up, because he gives us all a will, a free will. But if people open up the door to satanic things, then that causes those mental torments to come in. The Bible says that he brings in fear, and fear brings in torment. And, you know, it may sound good for a while, it may be fun for a while, but the end is destruction, the Bible says.
Absolutely. The Word of God says this, children, it is the last hour, just as if you've heard that the Antichrist is coming. Even now, many Antichrists have appeared. From this, we know, Linda, the Word says, we know that it is the last hour. Now, you can witness the Antichrist spirit at a massive rate right now.
Yeah.
It's on our social media. It's on all the major platforms. You know, the Google, you see suppression of truth and the uprising of false beliefs, false teachings. And so we see this rise of the Antichrist spirit right now. And the
yeah.
Word says, that's how we know it's the last hour.
Yeah. Yeah. And it says in 2 Thessalonians 2:9, it says, the coming of a lawless one is according to the working of Satan with all power, signs, and lying wonders. So he is going to deceive with, you know, again, there's, you know, some of these shows that they're all, you know, supernatural and stuff. But personally, I believe because we are Christians, we are to be walking in God's supernatural power. You know, the Bible says in Mark 16:20, he said he'll confirm his word with signs following his word. So when we preach his word, we can expect signs and wonders following. And I tell you what, just this week I had a sign and wonder. We had someone had called, and her husband had just had a stroke and had they could see a blood clot in his brain. And so we prayed, and we commanded that blood clot to be dissolved. A few minutes later, she called. She said they did another scan and it was dissolved, and they couldn't believe. They didn't know, you know, what happened. So, you know, that just shows you God's power. But we as Christians should have the power of God working, because there is a deceptive power of the enemy. And I think that's why kids are looking. They're looking for something because they know there is a supernatural out there, but they're looking in the wrong place.
That's absolutely true. And that, you know, the Word of God says the antichrists that are with us now, false prophets, false teachers, false Christ claiming to be Christ. So even false denominations, you know, even when you have these denominations that are misleading them, you know, that is a spirit, the spirit of Antichrist. And the Word says that's when you know it's the last days. It also says that you'll hear wars and rumors of wars. Well, Middle East is ripe for war right now. North Korea threats. You know, they could do more than threat with nuclear arms. China
yeah.
is well-armed army. So we can see Iraq and Iran, Saudi Arabia, mm-hmm. Persian Gulf crisis, the list goes on. Right now, we're witnessing that. Nation rising against nation, kingdom against kingdom. Famine and earthquakes is another sign. Now, the Word of God, I love this. The Word of God says, this is the beginning. This is not the end, it's the beginning of birth pangs. What does that mean? Linda, what that means is these things will intensify and they will be more frequent. So it's not that they haven't been around before, it's that they will intensify in their frequency. And they'll be stronger, just like a pregnant woman when she gives birth, those birthing pains get closer and closer and stronger and stronger. And that's what these signs, Jesus told his disciples, this is what's going to happen. And we're witnessing that. My daughter lives in North Carolina, and she called me the other day and she said, Mom, we had a 5.3 earthquake in North Carolina.
Yeah.
I asked her, did you feel it? And she said, I did. She felt the house shake. So, you know, we're seeing very strange weather patterns all over this country. I talked about the heat waves, you know, earthquakes, all kinds of things that Jesus taught his disciples. As these things get closer and closer, you're getting closer to the end of time.
Right.
And so I think it's important that we understand. He also said they will deliver you over to tribulation and you will and will kill you and you'll be hated by nations because of my name. Linda, if you there used to, in your day and my day, it used to be a time when you were at least respected as a Christian. Now you don't see even that respect coming from the world. You see vitriol, just open disdain. Which is so incredible that we see it in our lifetime, don't we?
Yes, yes. It's the persecution that Jesus was talking about and Paul is talking about here in 2 Thessalonians. You know, there's a hatred, and that's, you know, the deception. I mean, the enemy has been infiltrating the school system. I heard a statistic about colleges, people, Christians that go in, if a person goes in believing into a secular college, I think it was like, it was only 1 out of 5 or something like that come out still believing it is a Christian, because they're taught, they're humiliated, they're taught, they're made to be examples that they're stupid. And so, you know, it's a big persecution just upon the young people.
I had a friend, a son who went to UNC, Chapel Hill, and one of their classes, they had a comic book, and it was a pro-Palestine, anti-Semitic comic book, which they had to fill in the words. Now, can you imagine the indoctrination that would take on a child, on a young man's or young woman, having to sit there 250 pages and write out words of hatred?
Wow. So, you know, wonder there is so much hatred in the world, you know?
And God is love, Linda. God
yeah.
is love. He is the epitome of just the epitome of love. That's who he is. That is what he does.
Yeah.
And so when we look at these things, it's hard for us to understand such hatred coming against the love of God.
Yeah.
But it threatens people and it scares people and it forces people to look inward and say, do I need to change?
Yeah.
That's the beauty of the gospel. It brings change to hearts.
Yes. Amen. Well, and that's why it's so important in these last days that we demonstrate the love of God. I tell you what, the picture that's just etched in my mind, it was a policeman he went into the, you know, to these riot zones where all these young people are. And this one young man, he just, you know, he was talking to him. He just took time to talk to him. And the young man started like crying and he just hugged him. And I mean, I'm thinking, you know, that is really what it's all about. You know, these young people, you know, it's not that they're, you know, terrible young people are, you know, it's just that they've been led astray. They just need love. Some of them were not raised in a, you know, even in an environment where there was love. So you can't experience love if you don't know, if you've never experienced it, if you don't know what it is. And that's why as Christians, we need to be the light and the salt of the earth. And we need to demonstrate that love to these people. They just need somebody to listen to them because they think the world is all corrupted and there is no hope.
Yes. And, you know, it's important. And Apostle Paul taught this, share these words of encouragement. So because we're not like the world without hope.
Right.
Because we know the end of the story. And although these signs are real, they are growing in intensity and frequency, even though we know what's going to happen, the joy, Linda, is that we know that Jesus is going to return, and we know the church, the true church of Jesus Christ in the instant is going to be caught up in the air and taken out of this world. And that will be such a glorious, glorious time that we get to experience. But the importance, I think, of today's message is to understand for the viewer, the time is short. these signs, these indicators
Yeah.
of the last day, they are occurring, and we have to be able to identify and really understand where we are, like the sons of Issachar, who could discern the times and the seasons. That's what God really expects of his servants, to be able to discern the times and the seasons. We look at false prophets will rise, lawlessness will increase. We see lawlessness on the street at a rate I've never seen in my lifetime. The love of many will grow cold. And the word says this, but the one who endures to the end will be saved. And so, you know, there's this falling away. People are losing interest. They don't want to read their Bible. They don't want to come to church. They don't want to spend the time. But that's when you put yourself at jeopardy and you lose sight of what is going on and what is really important in this world.
Yeah, amen. Amen. The book of Revelation, the seven letters to the churches, those are not only past, but their present churches as well. And he always talked to them, to those who overcome will inherit, or they will be given certain things. So, and in 2 Thessalonians, we're encouraged to keep our eyes and to not be overcome by the things that are upon the earth. And so as we close up today, I want you to, you know, if there's any other signs you have, share those. And then also just share, you know, the hope that we have in Christ. And before you do that, I want to read, I want you to close off in prayer. And 2 Thessalonians 2 and verse 15 through 17, it says, therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold traditions which you were taught by, whether by word or our epistle. Now, may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and our God and Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting consolation and good hope by grace, comfort your hearts and establish you in every good word and work. As we wrap up the show today, just finish your thoughts up, and if you would, pray at the end.
Absolutely. One other sign, the gospel will be preached over the world. That's why we do these things, Linda, to reach the masses.
Amen.
And to share the good news of the gospel, and to let everyone viewing, time is short. Time is short. These things are signs of the end of the time. And what that means is Jesus could return this very day. I think it's really important that we understand there's signs in the sky. We see comets. We see all kinds of strange things happening in the sky. That's a sign. Increase will, knowledge will increase. Travel, people will go to and fro. That's going on right now. So as we look at all these signs, it should prepare our heart to be expectantly waiting on our Savior's return. That's the
Amen.
Good news, friends. He's coming back, and we're going up in glory. It could be today. If you are not ready, today is the day of salvation. The Word of God says, if you believe in your heart and you confess with your mouth, you will be saved. So if all of these signs put together has stirred in your heart, all you have to do is say yes to Jesus. Say, I was this, and now I want to follow you. I want to turn from my ways. I want to repent of my sin, and I want to make you Lord and Savior of my life. Friends, that's what you do, and you're guaranteed, you have an assurance that you will be in heaven with Jesus. No man knows the hour or the day, and no man is guaranteed tomorrow. So I want to pray now. Dear Heavenly Father, as we thank you for your word, which is so rich, it's so deep, it's so beautiful. God, that you left for us a manual of life. You left for us clear instructions on what to do, what to see, what to understand. And Father, you opened our spirit to receive the truth. As we're walking through the last of the last days, Father, we ask you to give us wisdom on how to share your word how to share your truth, how to share your glory, God, so that you will be lifted up. And as you are lifted up, Father, you said you would draw all men unto you. Now, Father, I ask you to bless everyone in the hearing of this broadcast today. I ask you to bless them physically, emotionally, spiritually, and mentally. I ask you to touch their homes and bring peace and unity into their house. We praise your holy name. You and you alone are worthy. In Jesus' name, I pray.
Thank you, Robin. You know, it's such a pleasure to have you on the show, and the word today on some of the signs of the time. Like you said, we need to know what they are so that we can be aware and be ready, be looking, be excited, be anticipating. And the Bible says we're to be about the Father's business. We're to be busy doing his work, not hiding away, but we're to be out proclaiming his good news. And that's what we're doing today. And we encourage you to do the same, to share this program with everybody you know. And, you know, whether they're saved or not, they need to know what Jesus is coming back soon and what his word says. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Linda.
Amen. So, Robin, if you would just share where people can get in touch with you.
Sure. RobinBertram.tv. Please visit my website. And join me on Facebook, Official Robin Bertram. If you jump on, just become part of my community. I share my thoughts, I teach, and I have wonderful uplifting scripture daily. So please join.
Amen, amen. I love talking about the Word of God with you because you have a passion for Jesus. So do I. So thank you for being on the program today. If you would like to watch this program again, you can see it at lindacross.com or livinghopecfc.com. That's where our live stream archives are and other programs as well. I also just got an Apple podcast program as well as a SoundCloud. So this will be posted on there too. But you can just check out lindacross.com. I'll post the things there as I get them edited and put up. But this live stream, you should be able to get, obviously, on Facebook right now. I'll be loading it up to lindacross.com and Living Hope CFC shortly. So thank you all for watching today. God bless you. And remember to be looking for Jesus. And most importantly, have him in your heart and be living for him. God bless you for watching. Thanks, Robin. And we need to continue. This is a topic that I think the people need to know about. God bless. Thank you all for watching and have a great rest of your day. God bless.